combining all the high hops, high hoops, and high hopes. It's easy to get dunk drunk off Ram Rim Risers. Especially when even JV like Noah Rogers fly to the flush. So how sobering a thought would it be if the Cram crew was denied a single real peel? The Silver Lining would still be in running its record to 12-7 while bursting the league last place Pirates bubble. Consider center Brandon Johnson has been busy punching up his bid for NAC 6 Player of the Year consideration. In his last game, he double whammy 26 points and 23 rebounds. So what does he do for an encore? Enough. 25 points, 16 rebounds, 3 blocks. And starting by winning the tip. Partner-wise, Brandon Williams began with a bang. Made in this fade. Then the big man dribble drove and dropped the box. Sensational. Then Williams pedaled while Johnson paddled. Tandem Terminators. The Rams wrapped 5 of their initial 6 shots, but could not gain much distance in the relay race approach. Though Williams no-no'd this Fogo. And Donovan Martin's snatch and dash yielded a will he or won't he moment. He settled for the safe bank under pressure. Next, he was whistled for a questionable goaltend. Johnson just kept demonstrating dominance at both ends. Corinth holders continue coming back for smacks. In an action-packed first period, where Justice Radway laid down the law on a 10-point spread. Brother Bishop Radway landed the latest lick from way away. The same ramp pace favored the host with the most. Darian Long supplied a long outlet to Martin, who dipsy-dooed the 8-nose spurt. Yet those pirates still hung around. Ram creativity, however, seemed to crush every guest chance. They were firmly positioned on the upside. Because Jalen Mathis's Chris Crawl to Sincere Lynch dissected the enemy zone. But a near miss messed up obliteration plans down the half stretch. Instead, three straight enemy trays generated a 9-0 intermission red alert. Requiring Roseville to regroup. Following this fourth triple threat in a row, the margin was reduced to a single. And this could have been the front burner. But when it was off the mark, Martin DeLong was on their mark, set, good. Not much breathing room, but there was some fresh air in places. Plus Johnson huffed and puffed around and around and around the post. A crucial juncture occurred after a technical foul. Pirates whittle the count to a pair with possession. Cue Bishop Radway takeaway. Then Bishop Key three. Corinth holders rally to the brink again. And somehow avoided this obvious TO. Though the tie tries failed. Allowing Morton to gain the final frame fortune. Thus, despite one final scare, Roseville steadied its balance to stay on top. Thanks to a double dose of Tim Robinson. A Williams Express delivery. A Mathis arch. And then, of course, a Johnson coast-to-coast throwdown. Which both knocked out a 9-0 flurry and ended the slam drought. A sloppy ram, 12th offensive error, was quickly corrected by a press-breaking backbreaker. Courtesy of Morton, the usual iron orbiter. From there, Williams completed his 6-point, 6-assist night. Morton committed his third steal and eighth assist upon juicing Johnson, who, well, double-double reinforced his MVP trophy case. pesky as the Pirates could be, an upset was not meant to be. Martin's 14th point and a Johnson freebie preceded one last second, access granted, Pirate highlight. It was little consolation considering Roseville's onward playoff positioning. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.